Alright, in this tutorial, I'm going to make you a nice website that looks something like this. And let's get started with a blank page. So you want to make sure you have the already HTML layout. And if you don't know how to do that, I suggest you look at my other tutorial on making an HTML layout. So this is the body tag, so I want to just change it because I want to change the background to not be ugly. Everything in the white space right now, or the canvas, is going to be what you see on the web page. So I want to change the background color to 444444 as the hex color. So let's just hit save because hex colors make the page look pretty. You can use standard colors if it's just generic. And there you go. So there you go. You have some nice coloring of the page. There you go. Alright, so now I want to actually put some text on the web page of your canvas. So in the body, we just want to type some text. So why not let us just type something nice and simple, such as, I don't know, hello world maybe. Yep, that sounds good. So I don't want to put a tag or anything. So let's just go ahead and put hello. Hello world. Explanation point. And refresh. You should get hello world. I know it's tiny, but it should turn out nice. But I want to change it to MicroTech Tutorials and show you something. This is a test, okay? So if you make some lines and save it and refresh, you'll notice it doesn't make it a new line. You actually have to use a tag because computers don't understand what lines are. Just like hitting enter, you have to make a tag for it, actually. So I just want to use the BR tag because that makes a new line. So just like hitting enter. So BR, BR. And there we go. So let's just cut and paste it before because I hate the default where it is. So refresh. And it should be a few lines now. Now, I actually want to make this easier to see because I'm doing a voiceover and I can't barely see the text from here. So let's just make this white. So let's change the font color to white and the size to positive 6. So save, refresh. There, I can see it now. So if I refresh, I got that. But you can also use the H1 tag, and let's talk about headers. So I can delete this. And we can actually use a thing called H1. H1 is the biggest font on the page, and H7 is the smallest header on the page. Notice that it is smaller than using the actual size tag. So if I want to make a new line, so just type in some gibberish, you know, slash H1, and then let's just put in H2. So H2, close that tag up. Refresh, and you get some nice new text. So as you can see, it makes the biggest one, H1 is the biggest, H7 is the smallest. So I like size better, that's just me. So size plus 6, you can also mess with CSS with H1 and stuff, but let's just change it back. I want to actually center this, so I should use the center tag, and it should center this text. So that's done. Now let's move on to actually inserting an image. So image source, src equals quotation mark slash 480p because that's just an image I had on the server. And just hit save. And you should get this image. You can change the size by going, not size, sorry. I don't want size. I want width equals 640 by 480 height, so 480, and there you go. So let's refresh, and it should make it a little bit smaller. There you go. And if we move it down, so let's just go ahead and move this page down some in the HTML coding. So let's just go ahead and I don't know, make a link. Let's make a link that says refresh. So let's make a refresh link. So ahref MicroTech Tutorials and click meet here to refresh and BR, and you should get a link that says refresh. So click here to refresh. Now, I can make this smaller if I want to, so. Yeah, let's make it smaller. And we want to end the font, and go ahead, font size equals. Nah, let's do H1. Just make it simple. Alright, just type that in. New tag, refresh. You should make it a little bit smaller. There you go, nice and smaller. And there you go. I'd actually put it before, but never mind. And you should get a nice link. And if you click it, it should refresh and waste a lot of bandwidth just refreshing. Click it over and over and over. Alright, so let's say I want to make an image link. So you can actually go ahead and combine tags. So you have the ahref tag and the image tag. So if you combine it between it, it should make an image that is link. So we can do slash, sorry, not a, slash image, and then slash a because saying a link, and this is what I want the link to be. So then let's just end this. So there you go. So refresh, and the image is now a link that refreshes it. So let's make a contact link. So Mailto is the link. So instead of putting HTTP, you want to put Mailto colon contact at whatever. So let's just do contact at microtechtutorials, which you can use to email me if you have a tutorial suggestion. So let's just go ahead and do I want to keep it? Click here to contact me. Explanation point. And let's end this link. And there you go. You should have a link that says contact me. So that's pretty nice. If you want to change the link color and underlining, that's actually in CSS, which will be covered later in another series because CSS is somewhat different, but you can. And you can change it to question mark subject equals whatever, but I'm just going to keep it at what it is right now. So let's keep it, and it should be looking good. These are just some basic tags. I will be covering more tags, such as font, images, image mapping, and such in another tutorial. I just wanted to get images, links, text, some basic text out of the way. So for more tutorials, make sure to check out Microtech Tutorials on YouTube, youtube.com/microtechtutorials. Make sure to subscribe to that in my side channel, TechTube Central. For more tutorials, check out microtechtutorials.com, and I'll catch you guys in another Microtech Tutorial. So have a good day, and I'll see you guys in the next part of this series. Thank you guys for watching, and goodbye.